Chair of the Puerto Rican Hispanic Task Force. Feliz Dia de los Reyes Magos.
Tonight we come to you live from HITN's studios in the Brooklyn Navy Yard.
Go Brooklyn!
Go Brooklyn, our home borough. Yes, we're excited to be here with all of you. Happy Three Kings Day to you, Assemblywoman.
Thank you.
Wasn't that first clip of the grandfather teaching his granddaughter the story of the Three Kings and the traditions so heartwarming?
Yes, it was. Abuelito was doing a great job with his granddaughter. It was very touching.
Now, this clip comes to us from Chicago's very own National Museum of Puerto Rican Arts and Culture.
It's important to teach our children about our culture and traditions, especially one such as Three Kings Day.
And we also just saw a clip with a number of your colleagues sending their greetings from their different districts across the state.
Yes, I appreciate their support full-heartedly, and I haven't seen them in quite a while, Janine. I miss them.
Yeah, because the pandemic has made the past month hard on all of us. Even the holidays were very different this year.
But we will not let COVID stop the task force and its mission. As you know, SOMOS has a long commitment to its students and community initiatives. This year, we're celebrating two important milestones with our programs. The 25th anniversary of the Model New York State Senate Session Project, and the 31st anniversary of the Puerto Rican Hispanic Youth Leadership Institute. We need to make sure that these programs are supported so that they can be available for our students. So when the world returns to normal, Janine, we can get back to the task of healing these future leaders. In fact, that's the theme of tonight's event. The future of the next generation is in our hands.
And hopefully we'll get back to normal soon. And that's an important responsibility, the one we all need to support. So we're looking to you for sponsorship, and we'll get updates on donations throughout the night. Please donate. No amount is too small. And tonight we're going to hear from students who have participated in the programs that you just mentioned. There's an award presentation later, and we've got lots going on here tonight.
Yes, we do. We're going to hear from other elected officials as well. And we're even going to learn about the history of SOMOS with a presentation being made by the new chair of SOMOS, Frank Diaz. So let us kick off the evening with the history of SOMOS.
As the new chair of this historical organization that was founded in 1985 by members of the New York State Assembly, its founding members were Assemblyman Angelo Del Toro from East Harlem, from the Boogie Down Bronx, Assembly Member Hector Diaz, and Jose Rivera, and Jose Serrano. And representing Brooklyn was the Lone Ranger Assembly Member Victor Robles.
We knew that it was a matter of time when this city, you will have a large movement of Latinos coming from all over. It was easy for us to tell that was the future.
Together, these members formed the New York State Puerto Rican Task Force, and afterwards guided the formation of SOMOS El Futuro, the not-for-profit conduit for the annual conferences held in Puerto Rico and in Albany. Together, these members embraced a common vision, a common purpose, to unite, to educate, to advocate, to organize, and to empower the Puerto Rican voices in Albany to build bridges between New York and Puerto Rico.
We set out to have the conference, three-day conference in Albany, but we have thousands of Latinos coming to speak to their elected officials.
We will remember the great past Puerto Rican legislators who chaired the task force. Assembly members Hector Diaz, Assembly member Peter Rivera, Roberto Ramirez, Felix Ortiz, Carmen Arroyo, and most recently, our youngest dynamic legislator, former member Marcos Crespo. However, today, we have another dynamic legislator, Assembly Member Marita Davila, making it clear that we will work together to help our youth and our communities. The mission of SOMOS is to raise funds, to provide scholarships for students in CUNY and SUNY, and to provide internship opportunities in the offices of the legislators in Albany.
So many youngsters involved in the mock session, giving them an idea that when they finish school, be whatever you want to be the best, but consider also to become an elected official, because this is where all the decisions are made that affects every one of the lives of our people in our city, in our community.
Your tax-deductible contributions today will benefit hundreds of youths for years to come. Thank you.
Our continued partnership with Latino and Hispanic legislators is critical as we build the ladders of opportunity so the next generation can climb even higher.
I also want to encourage all of you who are joining us virtually tonight to continue supporting the work of SOMOS.
It is more essential than ever to stay connected and celebrate our roots. I'm proud to participate in the Three Kings Gala and help SOMOS make that happen.
And there you have it, a track record of success, all possible with your support.
SOMOS has been committed to its students since the start, and that is why it's important to continue supporting.
And okay, so let's get a quick update on those donations. Let's see what we have here. $7,500, yay! We have donations from New York State Comptroller Thomas DiNapoli for $2,500. And we have a donation from Pfizer for $5,000.
Thank you so much for those donations.
Now, one of the sponsors, Pfizer, has been in the news lately due to the distribution of their vaccine.
Yes, and lots of people still have questions about the vaccine, Janine.
And that's true, people are worried, but this is to tell them that everything is safe, right? That's why HITN, we're here hosting this event tonight, partnered with Pfizer to help educate its viewers on the vaccine. And next, we have two clips that focus on two important student initiatives that we need to support. But before we get to those clips, let's take a quick look at an interview hosted by HITN's Doctora Alisa speaking about the vaccine with Pfizer's Chief of Scientific Affairs, Dr. Alejandro Cañé.
Dr. Cañé, welcome. We're delighted to have you.
Thank you for having me to be today here with you.
It's our pleasure. Now, how safe is a vaccine for those who take it? How does the vaccine work in the body? And what about the allergy cases?
In terms of the second part of your question, the allergy, we have seen two cases in the UK immediately after the vaccination campaign started there. But the good news is that after more than 22,000 subjects that were included in our clinical trial, we have half of them in the vaccine group, half of them in the placebo group, and we haven't seen any severe adverse events in terms of allergies, even if they had previously any allergic medical history.
Hello, everyone. My name is Ernesto Malave Jr., and I am the Assistant Director for the Edward T. Rogowski Internship Program at the City University of New York. The Model New York State Senate Session Project was launched in 1997. The project was developed by City University of New York. It received support from the State University of New York and was initiated at the request of the Puerto Rican Hispanic Task Force of the New York State Legislature. Over those years, the Model Senate Project has touched the lives of over 1,500 college students.
I came across the Model Senate Program through a flyer that was posted outside of the political science department. I thought it was a great program. It seemed really interesting, and so I enrolled, and the experience was life-changing, honestly.
The program itself is structured to give students an opportunity to understand all the facets of New York State government.
It was a tremendous program where I learned so much about the impact of local representation and the day-to-day issues that we face. Today, I am a vice president at the New York City Economic Development Corporation.
Many of the students have gone on to take jobs in government at every level, and some have even run for office.
I did the Model Senate program in 2010. I ended up working in the U.S. Capitol for U.S. Senator Tim Kaine. So I always say, if it wasn't for the Model Senate, there probably would be no U.S. Senate.
The impact that this program has on its students is incredible.
Some of the most memorable moments that I had, it was my experience in the training seminars on the state policy formulated.
In 2004, when this community became my family, my extended family, my community, and really brought me into a world that ultimately shaped who I would be for the better part of my better part of the rest of my life. But it's only with the Model Senate program we've been able to achieve the success that we have.
Thank you to all the members of the task force who worked so hard under such difficult circumstances.
On Three Kings Day, we celebrate a moment when the world looked to a new leader who championed our values and empathy.
When we begin the healing process in our state, you have my word that we will work with you to make sure Hispanic New Yorkers are not left behind.
Together, we will make sure that we build a future that works for all of our communities and celebrates the strength that comes from our diversity.
Feliz Dia de Reyes. Happy Three Kings Day to SOMOS.
For their incredible efforts this past year to educate and elevate the Latino community who was so much affected by the pandemic.
That's why it's more important than ever that we continue the traditions, rituals, ceremonies, and celebrations that define our communities.
On this day, I want to give you the gift of hope. Hope that our city will be safe again to enjoy with our loved ones and hope that 2021 will be better for all of us.
The Angelo Puerto Rican Hispanic Youth Leadership Institute is a program born over 30 years ago. It has been 3 decades of developing Hispanic leaders across the state of New York.
Every single student that comes through here has managed to bring themselves to the next level.
Angelo Toro felt that the Hispanic community was not engaged in the political process. They didn't vote, they were just not engaged. And he believed that if the Latino population is gonna have any voice, they need to be engaged in the political process.
It is a partnership between the New York State Education Department, the New York City Department of Education, SOMOS, Inc., and many other partners. We have trained thousands of students across the 30 years. Our students are very successful, and they attribute the success they have had later in their career to the learnings that they had during this program.
My name is Roderick Colmena.
My name is Joanna Garcia-Salas.
And I am an associate attorney.
And I was in Friday last year, my junior year of high school. My favorite part about it was actually just meeting all these new people and students from around the school and realizing we all kind of have something in common with the culture.
And that really got me thinking. You know, these are people who look like me, who have similar backgrounds, and they've accomplished so much. So why not me?
It's a great, amazing experience. I have no words to describe it. It's amazing. I really love it and I really appreciate every one of you guys.
So empowering. Those students are really impressive.
I agree. And the students who graduate from the programs continue to impress all of us every day. But as committed as SOMOS is to its students, it's just as committed to the community.
Let's talk about that commitment to community.
This year, their story. These are strong Puerto Rican women, Janine.
Woohoo! I can't wait. But before we do that, let's get a quick update on those donations. Let's take a look at our screen right now. We are up to 22,500. Woo! We have donations from Univision for $5,000, Con Edison for $10,000. Thank you to our sponsors.
Keep donating.
Now we have this clip we talked about, Puente Blanco. Kitchen, all of our sponsors, and all of you who have donated so generously that SOMOS continues to be a success. And now a clip from one of our sponsors.
We are the heart and soul of America. We wake up to grow, to dream, and to thrive. The New York hustle does not stop. It adapts. we will create a better, more vibrant, and economically flourishing community. And Univision New York will be there, as we have for 5 decades. Be part of our tomorrow, because we are New York tough.
Again, thank you to all of our sponsors.
To the members of the Puerto Rican Hispanic Task Force, SOMOS, all of my colleagues in government, thank you for your commitment to this incredibly important mission. Feliz Día de los Reyes and a very healthy and happy new year.
Healthy, healthy, that's key, right? Now this concludes our program, but your donations are still needed. Please find the donate button on the SOMOS Gala page. You could click and donate. Thanks again and good night.
Buenas noches.